Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy! Welcome back to more Okamiden in the last episode! We went back to Yakushi Village, got a few things done, got ourselves a brand new divine instrument, as you see there, the light sword. We also got ourselves a new rosary, but I'm gonna show that off a bit later because I want everyone to get a little screen time. So, now that my little rant is over, how about we start on something funny? Take it away, Kuro! So this here is the dojo. Someone really pummeled the heck out of it. I just always thought that line was funny, but I wanted to come back here to the dojo in Shinshu Field, because we happen to be in Shinshu Field right about now, and you might remember this pit behind the dojo. Remember how you needed Inferno to actually see what was in here? I'm being organized, aren't I? Okay. Isun Masterpiece Part 5. Yeah. No idea why they give us these so out of order, so... Just for clarification's sake, let me show you how out of order we're getting these now. We have part 1 and 2 complete. We're missing about half. We're missing half of part 3. And with still half of part 3 to go, they've given us a part 4 and a part 5. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe there's something I'm not understanding that's quite obvious as to why they did that, and that was kind of a weird shot, but... How about, now that we are down there, I will meet you guys back at Agata Forest, where we're going to be continuing with the story, because last video was kind of just all side questy stuff. So, see you guys there in just a moment. But wait, that's some interesting clothing choices you've made there. You like my digs, Pops? I knew you had some good taste. Good taste? I wouldn't be caught dead in something so ridiculous, says the man wearing a purple jumpsuit. It's your loss, clothes make the man, as they say. Yeah, we were in the area. I had to stop by and go check on Susano. Alright, welcome back to Agata Forest. So we're gonna start heading off toward Madame Fawn's place, and you might recall a certain area from before where we could use Cherry Bomb. We're gonna have Kuro cross the water for us, because remember, being able to fly kind of makes all obstacles that Nanami, Kagu, and, you know, that they could cross kind of, I guess, all null and void at this point, because you can just fly over whatever you want. So he's kind of the ultimate party member in the way of travel. Because you can kind of just go anywhere with them. We're going to go ahead and draw a cherry bomb right here. And let's jump down into the pit. What do we got here in this Nirvana hole? We have Isun Masterpiece Part 3. Okay, as soon as I say that we're missing half of Part 3, we're no longer missing half of Part 3. So we already got two major collectibles out of the way in this video. Not bad, if I do say so myself. But as I continue to take credit for things that the dev team did and not me... Let's move Kuro over there, skipping that island. Screw you, island, I don't like you. Thank you. Vine our way over, and let's see what is in that chest. Got ourselves a slip. Okay, we need to go ahead and grab that, because that is actually part of a manifest that we don't have quite yet, and believe it or not, it is actually a required manifest. I know, how often are manifests actually required? Not too often. In fact, I think this might actually be the first. Because, let's see, the pottery was not required, Rouse prayer equipment was not required, or Rouse treasures, excuse me. The journals are actually not required. In fact, I think this is actually the first case of a required manifest. I don't know, I could be always wrong about that. I don't know, I'm not, I tend to be wrong from time to time. Okay, I tend to be wrong most of the time. Well, I don't know if I'd quite say that, but... I'm saying is, I am wrong sometimes, I am human, and I am probably wrong about that. I don't know. But, I'm done beating myself up. Well, I'm not really beating myself, more like being realistic. Let's actually stop rambling and press on through the Agata Forest. And damn, that used a lot of ink. Holy crap. Didn't think that would use quite so much. So, nothing really over here. Can you actually go over here? Yes, you can. Oh, wow, Cherry Bomb area. I forgot this was here. Let's use that. And let's go in there. So, bit of a funny story. This is my third or fourth time trying to record this video because I actually was having some terrible luck. And I really, really should not jinx this by saying that it's working now. But I was having this issue where the capture card that I used to capture the bottom screen, for whatever reason, kept saying capture failed, capture failed, capture failed, capture failed before it would even start capturing. It was really freaking annoying, and I am really glad that it's working now, because that would have been really unsettling. I wanted to point this out, that we actually can't get that chest off there in the distance. I just kind of wanted to point out that it was here, and get a little bit of praise from that tree. But I just wanted to show the, you know, so you know it's here. Even though I didn't remember this area upon coming in here, I did remember the cave, even though I didn't remember exactly where it was located, so. Not much else to say there. Just wanted to show that it was there. So, whoa! Can I do that again? I can't. Oh, wait. That's odd. The wall, like, doesn't load the texture right away when you walk up to it. That's kind of funny, actually. Again, I guess you can't expect everything to be perfect. It is a DS game, but, you know. At least it's better than this if I was emulating this, because I'm not. Let's go over here. And hey, this chest is no longer on fire. Hey, I don't care about you. I want the chest. Okay, no, not really. Here we have a tanuki. Orf, orf. Sup. Orf, orf. You know a place with lots of peeps? Orf, orf. I'm running short on ends. Cough. Orf, orf. Never mind, I didn't say Jack. Orf, orf. Just tell me where the peeps are so I can go. Tell them how to reach Yuki's village? Orf. Orf, orf. That's supposed to be, eh? Orf, orf. Time to start making them ends again. Arf, arf, never mind, I didn't say Jack. Arf, arf, peace out. So, interesting thing about the tanuki. Aside from the crane, he is the only animal that counts as part of your human population to Yakushi Village. Did I say something rude to him? I like that. And here we get ourselves a bear carving. So there's a treasure right there. After using that much ink, I want to go ahead and grab this really quick. I don't really need to save, but it will restore our ink pots to full, which is always good. But as you remember a couple episodes ago, we have to go see Madame Fawn, because she will tell us where it is we need to go. What's the meaning of this? Just when the water recedes, I can go back to my fortune-telling in my own house. Demons, come and stole my fortune-telling equipment. Even though I foresaw this, destiny determined it should happen. However, I cannot see the future without my equipment. That totally blows. How about we do you a favor and look for your fortune-telling equipment? Really? I'll give you a list of what was stolen. Have a look at it. I was able to see the place where my things may be, so I've marked them on the map in red. Good luck. So, Madame Fawn's goods. Let's check this out. We already have the crystal and the slip. We got the crystal a couple videos ago, just reminding you. And we're missing two items. So, we want to take a look at our map of the Agata Forest, and I will meet you guys over by where those red circles are on the map. Alright, so the first one, we have to go up this ladder. I believe that we were here before when the forest was submerged because the water was not quite up this high. Yeah, actually, we did go up here. So we want to go back around here behind the entrance to Madame Fawn's place. Here we have a dandelion we can't do anything with quite yet. But, importantly, right up here we have a red demon scroll. Now, I suppose when we're fighting this enemy, this different demon scroll that is marked in red, I guess I can talk about something else. Because we've already fought this enemy before, and this is a required battle, so I do want to show it all the same. And that is that I'd like to talk about some more unused content in Okamiden. As you recall, a few episodes ago, I said that I'd talk about more unused content a bit later. There is another scroll that was found. It is a tutorial scroll. So, again, it's explaining a mechanic of the game that didn't make it into the finished product. It mentions demon scrolls with pictures on them that have special challenges that you must defeat the enemies under. And you'll apparently get big rewards for doing it. I have the scroll up on screen right now. Again, if you want to see the exact text, I'll have it in the description. But the odd thing about it is that no such thing existed in Okami, and the scroll also doesn't specify what kind of rewards this would actually yield. So this is kind of shrouded in a bit of mystery. There is one other scroll that was found. It's a history scroll, but it's a bit spoilery, so I'm not going to post the translation I have for that quite yet. Alright, and the last thing that we need to collect is right over here by Karude and Kokari's house. So, we're going to fight this red demon scroll and... frozen in place with the butthole in the camera! Wonderful shot. So, once again, I'd like to give a big thanks to... Rabbit and Tomato for that, because Rabbit found them, Tomato translated them, which I greatly appreciate. Alright. Let's. Whoa! Hey! Easy attack to counter. I need to power slash back at them. So. Can I still power slash you? Can I? Not quite. Power slash now? Nice! So. Now that we have power slash, I'll say that we're doing quite a bit. Kind of better here. Of course, as soon as I say that we're doing better, I get hit. God, this is so much better. Let's draw an N. Get magnetism to get two demon skins, of course. Want to deflect those back at you. And let's run up and combo them. Idea. I think you can actually use magnetism to... detach them from that, can you? Let's draw you. Nah, it didn't quite work. Oh, well, I still jumped out of the way of it anyway. That's odd. I could have sworn that you could do that. Let's go ahead and draw an N. Push them apart. And there we go. Got ourselves the odd necklace. An item that won't reveal the future. I like that. A large crystal that occludes... A large crystal that occludes vision, a slip of paper that brings for inscribing prayers, gives images of the future when heated, an item that won't reveal the future. So, we had to kill the toughest enemies to get the most useless item of all. Again, they are always jerks. Whoa, that was weird. This spazzed out when we were going up the stairs. So, back at Madame Fawn's, let's talk. Well, if it isn't my fortune-telling equipment that completes, this completes my entire set. Thank you so much. As a reward for finding my equipment for me, I will give you a free fortune-telling session. So she gives us some praise for that, and let's see. I got away with paying full price twice now. Yo, you think you tell me what my duty is? Certainly. Wow, let's see what these bones have to say. Yes, I see it. It's coming. So we're going to finally find out what Kuro was actually meant for. To set foot upon the clouds, you must go to the ghostly market. The feather you will gain will allow you to fly on the breath of gods. All I can tell you for now, the rest is up to you. Wait, you just told me about my wings. I didn't know what I have to do, dude. Then find these wings of yours is the first step on the journey. I feel like we just got taken for a ride. Anyway, we don't have any better ideas, so we'll do what she says. So we thought we were going to find out what Kuro was meant to do, but we did not. If you actually attack this gong, it gongs. I always thought that was kind of cool. Now, players of the first Okami remember that this area over here was the shortcut to Ryoshima Coast. However, it's blocked off. We can't do anything with that quite yet. So, no going back to Ryoshima Coast. We have to go to the Demon Market once again. So, if you missed anything in the Demon Market, now is your chance to try again. So, like I said, the point of no return before was not the point of no return forever. You just have to make sure that you get all the collectibles on this visit. Yo, what are those? What? You know what they are? Well then, let's see if you're right, boy. Reuse puzzle number 2312. Action! Wow, that was horrible. Like, that was really bad. Like, dang. I did draw a star! There we go. Third time's a charm. God, I did a horrible job drawing it there. Whoa! No turning back now. Let's go.